of Saint Martin's Engineering College, Hyderabad. So today we are going to talk on the topic population forecasting. Okay. So what is forecasting? Means predicting. Okay. So forecasting means predicting. So what we predicting here? So we are predicting the future population. So the population after 1 decade, 2 decades, 3 decades, so on. So we are predicting the future population, and that future population we are going to take into the designing of any water distribution system. Okay. So why we need to take this future population? Okay. So why not the present population? So why we need to do this forecasting population? Okay. Why we have to forecast the population? Suppose, for example, so there is a city. Okay. So let us assume there is a city A, and the present population of the city is 10,000. So just an example, we are taking it as an example. Okay. So now there is a city A I have considered. So the present population of the city is 10,000. So now my aim, I am an environmental engineer. So now I need to design a water distribution system for this city. Okay, I have to decide the water distribution system. So I have to lay the pipelines. So water pipelines I have to lay in this city, and also I have to design a water treatment plant. Okay, I have to design a water supply scheme. So now this population of the city is 10,000. To design a water supply scheme of any area of any city, I should be aware of what quantity of water I have to treat and what quantity of water I have to send to the public per day. Okay, so means in simple way, I should be aware of what quantity of water is required. Means what is the water demand of this area? Okay, so if I know the total water demand, so then only I can design a water supply scheme for this city. Okay, to decide this water demand or to calculate this quantity of water, so that is in demand for the public. Okay, to decide this water demand, I should be aware of per capita demand and population. Okay, so to decide the quantity of water required or to decide the total water demand, I should have the idea of what is the per capita demand of that area and what is the population of that area. So now what is this per capita demand? So the word itself says per capita demand. So what quantity of water is required per capita? Capita means per head or per person. Okay. So what quantity of water, so or how much liter of water is required for one person for one day? So that is nothing but per capita demand. So to this per capita demand, if you are going to multiply with the total population, then we are going to get this water demand. Okay, so to have the idea of the total water demand, we should be aware of the per capita demand as well as the total population. Okay, how we are going to decide this per capita demand? So we know that there are various types of water demand. Okay, so domestic water demand, institutional water demand, commercial water demand. Okay, and the water that has been lost in thefts. Okay, we have different types of water demands. Okay, so you are well aware of that. So by knowing that water demand, okay, so whether that this city is an industrial area or it is a residential area, whether it is a commercial area, so by deciding, by considering all the water demand, okay, whether fire demand, okay, different types of water demands are there. So by considering all that water demand, we are going to conclude one per capita demand. Okay, so after deciding the per capita demand, we will go for the calculation of the population. Suppose I have taken an example of, for the city the population is 10,000. Let's assume the per capita demand is 180. LPCD. What is this LPCD? Liter design a water distribution system. Okay, I'm going to design the water distribution system and also I'm going to design the water treatment plant. Okay, already I have constructed and everything has been done. So now after 10 years, means one decade, the population may increase to 20,000. Again next decade it may become 30,000. Okay, so always we know that the population is not at a constant value. So due to births, migration or due to the deaths, so the population will be varying. So from decade to decade the population will be varying. So now I have taken the present population and I have designed the water treatment plant. I have fixed the diameter of the pipe and I have laid and also I have designed the water treatment plant. So sedimentation tank size, detention time and coagulation size, coagulation tank size, so everything has been decided and constructed. So but after 1 decade the population of from 10,000 it has been increased to 20,000. Okay, it means the quantity of water utilization is increased. Okay, now you have to supply more amount of water, you have to treat more amount of water. So now what will happen, so whatever the distribution system you have installed and whatever the water treatment plant you have designed or constructed, it will become no valid. So now by utilizing this water treatment plant and these pipes that have been laid, okay, so now they are unable to service the public. So now they are unable to provide the quantity of water that has to be supplied to the public. Now they are not in service. Okay, they have become obsolete. Okay, so hence what we are going to do, so also we know that while designing or while laying, so it will be an economical, okay, so it will not be that economical. So we are going to spend so much of money for design of this water pipelines or for the construction of the water treatment plant. So now after just for the 10 years now this water treatment plant or design distribution system has become obsolete. Okay, so now they are not able to serve the people. Okay, so in such cases what will happen, so whatever the investment you have done, okay, at present, so it will become of no use. So hence always we have to design the any water structures. It will be intake structure, a sedimentation tank, coagulation tank or a filtration bed or any distribution system. Okay, so anything or any water structure we have to design it for the next 30 years, next 20 years or the next 30 years. Okay, that period that we are going to fix is called as design period. Okay, so now what is the design period? So it is the period fixed or taken for the design of any water structure. Okay, so that to that period that structure will be under service. Okay, so that is called as design period. So hence we have to take this future population. So the next 30 years we have to predict the population and that population we have to take now and we have to design. So that even after the 30 years or the 20 years, so next 2 decades or 3 decades, we don't have any problem in the supplying of the water to the public. So for this reason we have to forecast the population. So hope it is clear to everyone. So for predicting this population forecasting we have different methods. Okay, so arithmetic increase method, geometrical increase method, incremental increase method, decrease rate method, graphical extension method, graphical comparison method, zoning method. So this zoning method is also called as master plan method, ratio of correlation method, growth composition analysis method, and the last one is logistic curve method. So these are the 10 types of other methods for the predicting the population or for the population forecasting. So among this 10 method, the first 4 methods are very important and widely used. So let us discuss the first 4 methods one by one for the population forecasting. The first forecasting method is arithmetical increase method. So it is written short form as AIM method. constant. So the average increment in the population of each decade is taken as constant. That is nothing but dp by dt is equals to k. So where dp is nothing but change in the population or increase in the population. Not only increase, it can tell it is a change in the population with respect to the time is constant. So this is the main assumption in this method. That is nothing but increase in population from decade to decade is constant. Okay. So now we are going to, so suppose if we know the from census data, if we know the past of 3 to 4 decades population, suppose 1930, 1940, 1950, 1960. So just take an example. So suppose if we know the population of this decade, okay, if we know the population, suppose X1, X2, X3 and X4. Okay, suppose if we know the population or the census data of the past 3 to 4 decades, okay, so we can find out the increment or the increase in the population for each decade. So whether it may be a positive value or it may be a negative value, okay. So we are going to calculate increase in the population, okay, for one decade, I mean between the each decade. So after finding the increment or the increase in the each decade, we are going to take an average increment value. So we are going to take the average value of these three. So that is nothing but increment. So the average increment value is calculated. So this average increment, by using this average incremental method, we are going to use the population formula. So in the arithmetical increase method, the formulation, the population for the next forecasting method is Pn is equals to P0 into n into x bar, where Pn is the population for the next n decades. So n means number of decades. So if for the next 20 years, if I find it, so n I will take it as 2. So if for the next 30 years I am finding, so then n is will be 3. Okay. So Pn is the population for the next n decades, that is equals to P0 means the present population plus n, that is number of decades, into x bar. What is this x bar? Average of this incremental value. Okay. So average of this increased value, that is by using this formula we can find out the population for the next decade, that is Pn is equals to P0 plus n into x bar. Okay, usually this method is applied for the forecasting population for the larger cities. So hence, already I have told you that this is going to give you the lower results. So if the larger cities or the developed cities already will be reaching the saturation population, so the population variation will be very less. Okay, to that type of cities we are going to apply this kind of method. Second method for the population forecasting is geometrical increase method, and it is denoted as GIM. Okay. So here in this method we are going to assume that the percentage increase in the population from one decade to another decade is constant. So in arithmetical increase method we have considered only increase from one decade to another decade is constant. Here we are taking percentage of increase. Okay, so percentage of increase of the population from one decade to another decade is constant. Okay, so the population forecasting formula for the future population we are going to calculate by using this formula. Pn is equals to P0 into 1 plus R by 100 raised to n. So already you know Pn is nothing but it is population after n decades, that is nothing but future population. P0 means the present population and n means number of decades. So now what is this R? R is nothing but it is assumed growth rate. So it is taken in the percentage. Okay. So R is nothing but assumed growth rate. Okay. So usually this method is going to give you the higher result. So whatever the population forecasting you are going to do, so I have told you in arithmetical increase method you are going to get the lower results. So whereas in the geometrical increase method you are going to get the higher results. Okay. And this method is usually applied for the rapidly growing cities. Okay. So where end cities are still developing cities, we are going to apply this method. Okay. So population. So if you know the 3 to 4 decades of population, then you are going to calculate the average. Means you are going to take the average of incremental increase. I mean, so increase is some percentage increase. Okay, you are going to take average value of increase method, and by using this formula, that is R is equals to R1 into R2 into R3 into R1 raised to n by 1. So you are going to calculate R by using this formula. I utilize that R value in this formula, you are going to get the future population. So this is what about geometrical increase method. The next population forecasting method, the third forecasting population forecasting method, is incremental increase method. So I have told you, in arithmetical increase method we are going to get the lower result, whereas in geometrical increase method we are going to get the higher result. Whereas the in incremental increase method we are going to get not the lower value, not even the higher value. So we are going to get the accurate. So usually the population forecasting cannot be done accurately, it's just a prediction. So but the incremental increase method, so we are going to get not even the lower value, not the higher value. So we are going to get the appropriate result in this incremental increase method. So hence, compared to the arithmetical increase method and geometrical increase method, incremental increase method is the most widely and commonly and efficiently used population forecasting method. So here the formula used is Pn is equals to P naught plus n into x bar plus n into n plus 1 by 2 into r. Okay, so this incremental increase method is nothing but it's a combination of both arithmetical increase method and geometrical increase method. By seeing the formula itself, you can see that it is a combination of arithmetical increase method and geometrical increase method. Okay, so here by using this formula you are going to calculate the future population. So here the main thing is you are finding increase in the incremental. Okay, so you are finding incremental in the increase. So in the job, in the arithmetic method, you are finding increase of the population per decade. Here, after the finding the increase, so again you are finding what is the increase. Okay, that is nothing but incremental increase you are finding, and that average of the incremental increase you are going to take it as R value. Okay, so the fourth and the final method of the population forecasting is decrease rate method. Okay, so we know that the population growth takes place only up to a certain limit. So after that saturation point has been reached, the population growth will be having a downward trend. So in that case, we are going to take this decrease rate method. Okay, so usually this decrease rate method is applied for the old cities where already the population has been reached in a saturation point and we have the growth rate. Okay, the rate of growth shows a downward trend. So when we are going to plot a graph for the population of old cities, we are going to get a S-curve. Okay, so it shows that, so after reaching a final point or a saturation point, we are going to have a decreased downward trend population. So in such cities, we are going to apply this method, that is decrease rate method. In this method, we are going to find out average decrease in the percentage increase. Okay, so first we'll find out percentage increase in the population of each decade. So after finding the percentage increase, we'll find out how much there is decrease in the each decade, and we are going to take the average value. And by using this formula, Pn is equals to P into n minus 1 into n plus r minus r dash by 100. Okay, so what is this r? So this r is used in geometrical increase method, that is percentage increase in the population, and r dash is percentage decrease in the population. So that we are finding in the decrease rate method. So obviously Pn and n value is already, I have told you, that is n is nothing but number of decades. So these are the overall view of a population forecasting methods. Thank you.